As you can see here in the final video, the milk drops are frozen as a static part of the image, and the only thing that is moving is the honey that's flowing on the slice of bread. So I'm scrubbing through the timeline here until I can find a specific frame that I want to freeze in time. So that's the frame. Now I will press Ctrl, Shift, Alt, and E to make a stamp visible layer, and I rename it to Freeze. And you can see this video group one with both the video file and the image. And what I will do is to drag the image out from this group and place it on top. You can see that the layer has its own track now here on the timeline. And for the moment, I'm just gonna hide this layer. Okay, now I need to find a specific segment of this long 48 seconds video file that will work for the CINEMAGRAPH. This segment needs to be loopable, and what I mean by that is you have to find a frame in the video that's gonna be the beginning, and you need a second frame that's gonna be the end, preferably to be very similar with the first one. So I already marked down my points on paper. The first frame where I will make a cut is here where the honey is flowing in a straight line. So I will make a cut here using this scissors icon and then move approximately 2 seconds or so forward to this frame, which is similar to the first one, and make a second cut. Keep in mind that when you're creating loopable GIFs, they need to be short, like 1 or 2 seconds. And for Instagram or Facebook, you can export short video files as well, because they will play over and over again for the users. Now that I have my cuts in place, I select the part before the cut, I press delete, and I do the same for the last part. Let's move the stamp visible layer to the front of the timeline, make it just as long as the video sequence, and you can see that the work area has been adjusted automatically. I can always zoom in and out with these two icons here, or I can use the slider and drag it left or right. And I can press on the spacebar to play the video, but as you can see, we don't have a loopable animation just yet, so we need to work on this right now. I'm gonna unhide the freeze layer, apply a layer mask to it, make sure the foreground and background colors are reset to white and black by pressing D on the keyboard, and now I need to paint with black on the mask. So I press B for the brush. With a hardness of 50%, I will paint over the areas that I want to be hidden on this layer, because underneath I have the video file, and as soon as I paint with black over this mask, the flowing honey will be visible. And also a small tip, if you want to see what you are painting on the mask, press the backslash on the keyboard. Let's press the spacebar to play the animation, and you can see that this looks much better now. The only part that's moving is the honey. You will need to adjust and readjust the mask if you want the CINEMAGRAPH to look really good, so you can zoom in on different areas, make sure the mask is selected, and paint with white when you want to hide areas, and with black to unveil other areas. You can easily switch between white and black using the letter X on the keyboard. So maybe you need to take care of some parts when you are really zoomed in. Maybe press the spacebar to play the animation again and check for tiny errors. You can also use different flow percentages for the brush so that you can fine-tune the mask and make it look very good. But we are not finished yet, because if I play the video, you can clearly see I still have a hard jump at the end of the video in this area and in this area. So how do I solve this? Well, it's very simple, let me show you. I select the video layer and I make a cut approximately at the middle. I have two video files here in the group. I will rename them to 1 and 2, and then drag the number 2 out of the group, just like this. On the timeline, each of the two video clips has its own layer now, and I will simply switch their positions. I will place the layer 2 at the beginning of the timeline and layer 1 immediately after layer 2. And yes, you are right, when I play the video again, it will look exactly the same. But now I have the possibility to fine-tune the hard cut because I moved it to the middle of the video. Now I select layer 1 and I will simply extend it a few frames to the left so that the two clips are overlapped. I select layer 2, go to this icon that has transitions, and drag the fade transition on layer number 2, just like this. This right here is the fade effect. You can make it shorter or longer. I will keep it at this size, but depending on the CINEMAGRAPH that you want to create, you will need to adjust it accordingly. As you can see, the hard cut is now more soft and it's barely visible. Only a trained eye will notice it, trust me. Now let me show you how to crop and export this video or GIF for Instagram. And if you want to see how I spilled the milk on the table while I was trying to film my first CINEMAGRAPH, just watch this video until the end and I will show you that sequence. It's so embarrassing. So on my Instagram, I decided to go with a 4:5 ratio because I wanted to win some space left and right and not just make it a 1:1 square. To do this, just select the crop tool in Photoshop and from this dropdown, choose 4:5. And you can press X to switch from landscape to portrait if needed. Using the rule of thirds, I position the flowing honey on one of the thirds. This way I also get the milk in the frame, so that is cool, and then I just hit enter. Let's choose the proper resolution for the file from image, image size, and enter 1080 for the width of the video, and the height would be adjusted automatically if this icon is checked right here to keep proportions. I press OK, this message could pop up, just click on convert and you're good to go. And then to render it as a regular video, which I recommend for Instagram, you just need to go to File, Export, Render Video, choose H.264, choose a folder and a name, and then click OK. If you want to use it as a GIF, go to File, Export, Save for Web, choose GIF from this dropdown, and click Save. But just as a tip, a CINEMAGRAPH will look much better when it's saved as a video instead of a GIF. So this was my first try for the CINEMAGRAPH, pouring the milk in a glass. And as you can see, it didn't end up well. So if you want me to make a video on how you should film a CINEMAGRAPH and what to keep in mind when doing it, but also what tools do you need to create a CINEMAGRAPH, just comment below and I will make a video.